Hi, this is Dan here from Math for Love, here with the second part in a subtraction series. And this is really about making sense of subtraction so you really understand it. I want to talk about the problem 32 minus 15. Now, if you were to just tackle this problem right away, you probably know an algorithm to do it, and you cross the 3 off, and then you add a little 1, and you do it, right? The problem with starting with an algorithm like this is it hides the meaning. There's meaning there, but it's hidden. It's hard to see. And whenever we're doing something new with numbers or with mathematics, we want to start from understanding. We want to start from a place where it makes sense. So what I'd like to do with this problem is see if we can make sense of it. And when it comes to subtraction, multi-digit subtraction, where we're doing subtraction with respect to the place value system, there's really 2 different elements that we need to keep in mind that will help it make sense and will actually help it be easy even as we go to multiple longer digits and into decimals and tenths and hundredths. Here's what they are. The first thing is that a subtraction problem with respect to place value is really multiple subtraction problems. Let's change it a little bit. Let's say we're doing 32 minus 11. So the 32 isn't really just one number. I mean, it is one number, but it's being expressed in terms of certain groups. The 3 isn't just a 3, it's denoting 3 tenths. So what we have here is 3 tenths and 2 ones. In fact, the word 30 is really just an old English way to say 3 tenths. And frankly, if we still said 3 tenths, this would probably all be a lot easier and more understandable right away. So we have 3 tens and 2 ones. We want to take away 11, which is 1 ten and 1 one. How do we do that? Well, we basically could just handle each one separately. We say, oh, I've got these 3 tens. I'll take away 1 ten. I have 2 tens left. Great. I have 2 ones. I want to take away 1 one. I have 1 one left. Great. That leaves me with 21, 2 tens and 1 one put back together. So I just basically treat each thing, each place, as its own separate subtraction problem and do each one separately. That's the first main idea of how place value works with respect to subtraction. So that's great, and this tends to be pretty natural for kids. Algorithmically, it feels more straightforward, I think. It's the second piece that makes it a little more tricky, and that's the idea that if we are back to our original problem of 32 minus 15, when we build 32 out of the blocks and try to take away 1 ten and 5 ones, which is what 15 means, we can take away the 1 ten, but we don't necessarily know how to take those 5 ones away from the 2 ones. And what's nice here is that the groupings, the group of 10, can be broken up into ones. I can choose to say, you know, those 3 tens and 2 ones, why don't I break one of those tens up into its component pieces, into its ones? Now I have 2 tens and 12 ones. I have kept the number the same, but I'm changing the groupings so it's more convenient to take things away from them. With 2 tens and 12 ones, I can now take away 1 ten, that one in the 15, and 5 ones, the 5 and the 15, from each of my pieces. 2 tens minus 1 one is, minus 1 ten is 1 ten. 12 ones minus 5 ones is 7 ones. So I have 1 ten and 7 ones, 17. Notice that if we build it and actually do this, the process is exactly the same as what we get when we use the algorithm. We change the 3 tens and 2 ones into 2 tens and 12 ones. The talk of borrowing is kind of obscures that, but what's really happening is we're just taking the same number and grouping it differently. That allows us to do the subtraction in kind of the easy way, and it all works out. And what's great is once you learn how to do this with 2-digit numbers, it's the same with 3-digit numbers and 4-digit numbers and decimals also. It's all the same principle every time. You just treat each place as its own separate subtraction problem and are willing to regroup to break up a 10 into ones, or break up 100 into tens, or a 1 into tenths, so that you always have enough to subtract. That's how the algorithm makes sense. That's how it's understandable. And that's really how how subtraction can be understandable, no matter how many digits you're working with. I hope this helps. Good luck doing subtraction, no matter the size, at home with your kids.